Good afternoon. Today we celebrate the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time. There is a special collection for the Church Maintenance Fund. Thank you for your generosity. Please turn off all electrical devices. This Mass is being offered for all of us and our families, and especially for John Elms, Justine Cave, Ellie Brommel, Mary Marilyn Bitzer Allard, Scott Conroy Harper, Jack Collada, Sarah Champagne, Arthur Mounts, Joan Schott, Judge Patrick M. Schott, Pierre F. Lepere Sr., Anthony L. Zapardo, Anthony E. Zapardo, Mary Ross Barrage, Randy Eckstein, Jack Sullivan, Sammy Bruglio, Diane Burns, Rita May Federico, Raymond Key, Adair Simpson, special intentions of Audrey Simpson, special intentions of Kathy and Tommy Sullivan, special intentions of Peter Sullivan, and special intentions of the Siciliano family. Please rise and join in singing our opening hymn number 270, 10,000 Reasons, in your Blue Spirit Songbook number 270.
Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped up in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. As we listen to our readings, in our first reading, we hear about a woman who is rewarded for showing hospitality to Elisha. And in our gospel, we hear about Jesus talking about the cost of being a disciple, but also the reward that goes with that.
A reading from the second book of Kings. One day Elisha came to Shunem, where there was a woman of influence who urged him to dine with her. Afterward, whenever he passed by, he used to stop there to dine. So she said to her husband, "I know that Elisha is a holy man of God. Since he visits us often, let us arrange a little room on the roof and furnish it for him with a bed, table, chair and lamp, so that when he comes to us, he can stay there." Sometime later, Elisha arrived and stayed in the room overnight. Later, Elisha asked, "Can something be done for her?" His servant, Gehazi, answered, "Yes. She has no son, and her husband is getting on in years." Elisha said, "Call her." When the woman had been called and stood at the door, Elisha promised, "This time next year, you will be fondling a baby son." The word of the Lord. Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in the newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Jesus said to his apostles, "Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet, because he is a prophet, will receive a prophet's reward. Whoever receives a righteous man, because he is a righteous man, will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink, because the little one is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward." The Gospel of the Lord. So on the feast of Corpus Christi, I use a triathlon or racing analogy, saying that it would be crazy to spend 2 hours on a race and not take in enough calories to give you fuel for that race. I compare that to spiritually, it would be crazy to try to live life without us consuming the body of Christ, the very source of our life. Now I want to use another racing analogy today. In college, I had a friend who got me involved in triathlon. I joined a club, really didn't know what I was getting into, didn't even think about racing, but I got into it. He signed us up for the race, lent me a bike, and when I raced, I was hooked. It made a difference. The next several years, I was just kind of consumed with that. I wanted to race more and more and to train more and more, and I made a lot of sacrifices. I had to eat healthier, be in better shape, sacrifice some social time with friends, give that up. Really had to cut back on doing most other things because it took up a lot of time. One of the biggest sacrifices was having to wake up super early in the morning, sometimes for the race day, to drive across the state or to another state, potentially. But the sacrifices were always worth it. I always enjoyed the race. So even if you're not into sports and have that sports mind, we can all appreciate that if there's something we like to do, we have to sacrifice to do it. We have to give something up, time, energy, money, whatever it may be. Sacrifice or giving something up is essential also to our Christian life. And when we do, we gain a reward. That's what our readings were about today. Jesus says, "Whoever loves their fathers or mothers or sons or daughters more than me is not worthy of me." Now these words, they can seem kind of harsh at first, but they remind us of the proper order of love in our lives. God first and everything else second. Now, loving God first doesn't mean that we don't love fathers, mothers, sons, brothers, sisters, but it does mean that we put Him first no matter what. And when we do, actually, we're able to love others more effectively, more deeply. But there are times in our lives when we're called to give up relationships. If a friend is not bringing us closer to God, we may need to give up that relationship and step away so that we can pursue God and become more holy without them. Sometimes when we put God first in our lives, unfortunately, it causes division in families. No doubt this happened to many of Jesus' first followers, those who didn't believe that Jesus was the Messiah. And Jesus was sending his first disciples out. He tells them that many will hate you, many will reject you, even family members. And he tells them again today in the gospel that they must love God even more than their family. But there's always a reward when we put God first, when we put Him number one, higher than anything else. We saw in our first reading this woman who served Elijah with her hospitality, welcomed him into her home, and her reward was a son that Elisha promised her. The prophet Elisha himself was familiar with sacrificing in order to gain reward. When the prophet Elijah came to him and said, "If you are called to also be a prophet, come follow me," Elisha said, "Let me first go tell my father and mother goodbye." Elisha says, "Okay, you may go." Elisha boils his oxen, saying, "I'm done with farming." He gives his meat to his family, and he tells them goodbye. And he goes to be a prophet under the study of Elijah. He gives up everything. And when Elijah is taken into heaven, we read that Elisha himself receives a double portion of Elijah's spirit, meaning he's become a holy prophet himself, destined himself for heaven, his great reward. There's a similar interaction in the Gospel of Luke, if we remember, where Jesus meets a man and says, "Come, follow me." This man responds. He says, "Let me first go bury my father." And Jesus, again, seemingly harshly, says, "Let the dead bury the dead." In a way, Jesus is telling this man, following me is more important than burying your father. It's more important than your family at this point. And this is our Christian life. It's extreme. It's extreme to follow Jesus. It's not just something we do when it's convenient or when we don't have anything else to do. We have to choose God first every situation in our lives. By telling this man not to worry about his father, Jesus was telling him, keep God first, and there will be a great reward for you. Another time, a rich man asked Jesus, he says, "How do I get to heaven? Tell me, show me." Jesus says, "Give up everything and follow me." Then we read that he went away sad because he wasn't able to give up everything to follow Jesus. Right after that interaction, Peter says, "Lord, what about us? We have already given up everything to follow you." And Jesus responds, indicating that there is reward for those who give up. He says, "When the Son of Man sits on his glorious throne, you who have followed me will also sit on 12 thrones. And everyone who has left houses or brothers or sisters or father or mother or wife or children for my sake will receive 100 times as much and will inherit eternal life." And then in today's gospel, Jesus says, "Whoever loses his life for my sake will find it." It's not easy to always put God first and to be willing to sacrifice for his name. It's not easy to always put him as number one, even before family, but when we choose Christ, we always receive a reward. Sometimes we see and notice that reward in this life. Sometimes we're fortunate enough to notice that the more we pray, the more peace we experience, the more patient we can be with others. Sometimes we don't notice that reward immediately. We're called to be more patient and trust. Trust that when we put God first, there will be an eternal reward in heaven. I'd like to make one more analogy with the sport analogy. When my friend first invited me to triathlon class, like I said, I had no idea what I was getting into. I had no idea how much I'd enjoy the race. But once I experienced it, that kept me wanting more. kept me wanting to experience the joy of it more and more. Similarly, in our Christian lives, unless we experience a relationship with Jesus, unless we experience him in the sacraments, the Eucharist, penance, reconciliation, unless we pray to him, it's really hard to sacrifice and to give up other things for him. But when we do, when we come to him in prayer, when we experience him, it's this great love, this great mercy that just it compels us continually to choose him, to make those hard sacrifices in our lives. So on earth, we will always have to sacrifice. And at times, we experience and notice the rewards of our sacrifices. But ultimately, when we experience Jesus' love in prayer and the sacraments, we want more and more of this same love. And we're inspired. We're inspired to give up everything, to order everything we do towards him and towards gaining that ultimate reward with him in our home in heaven. Stand as we confess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, was upon the Virgin Mary, and became for our sake, he was crucified and conscious by. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated in the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is the Lord and the Lord of God, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and life for the world to come. Trusting in God's loving care for each one of us, we offer the following prayers.
That, as our nation celebrates its independence, we may give thanks to God for our national freedoms, including religious freedom, and seek to acquire the spiritual freedom that God desires for us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For spiritual conversion in our nation, and for the preservation of religious liberties and all life from conception to natural death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis' prayer intention for the month of July, that Catholics may place the celebration of the Eucharist at the heart of their lives, transforming human relationships in a very deep way and opening to the encounter with God and all their brothers and sisters, we pray to the Lord. That through the intercession of Our Lady of Prompt Succor, we will be spared damage to life and property during this hurricane season. We pray to the Lord. For God's blessings on the people of China, Cuba, Iraq, Afghanistan, Nicaragua, and Ukraine as they struggle in the face of persecution and violence, we pray to the Lord. For healing of all who are sick or suffering physically, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually, we pray to the Lord. For our deceased loved ones, especially for the recently deceased, we pray to the Lord. Please join in saying our family prayer, which is on the inside front cover of the gathered hymn book. Following that prayer, we will recite a Hail Mary, for peace in Ukraine, and for the cause of life and godly values in our nation.
Let loving and faithful God, through the years we have been of our sacrifices, have appreciated the prayers of love of our Lady of Prosper in times of war, disaster, and heavy illness. We come to you, Father, Mary, our Mother, and ask you to help us in battle today against violence, murder, and racism. May the Lord be with your children, that we may build the community founded on the knowledge of Jesus, which gives respect to the life and community of all people. Bless parents and the informed of children in the faith. Bless and protect our youth. Consolation to those who have caused us all comes through violence. Hear our prayer and against the perseverance, give the voice of life and human dignity to our community. We ask this in Christ our Lord, our Lady of Prosper, peace and help us. Mother, our Mother, the Lord, pray for us, that we may be able to hold our prayer. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Bless us, our power and our name. Bless us,
singing our offertory hymn number 354, Take Up Your Cross, number 354 in your blue spirit songbook.
The tree from which salvation flew.
graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder. You rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. And so, with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration, we acclaim. All of you will eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. Sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Francis Xavier, with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Gregor, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow the world, all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Thank you.
away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you shed down my roof, but only say a word for my soul. Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that, bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the announcements. Tomorrow is our 4th of July concert at 3 p.m. in the church with Sarah J. McMahon and Lyndon. Complimentary hot dogs from the Knights of Columbus will be served in the pavilion area from 1:30 to 2:45. All are invited. A special thanks to City Park Physical Therapy for being a major sponsor of this event. St. Francis Xavier is going to the movies Tuesday, July 4th for the 6:40 p.m. feature of Sound of Freedom, a great movie that raises the awareness of the evil of human trafficking, particularly child trafficking. At AMC Elmwood, we'll meet at Lit Pizza, 5 p.m. Elmwood, and at AMC Elmwood is where the movie is. See the bulletin for details and ticket information. We will have part two of the School of Marriage with our deacons and their wives this Wednesday, St. Joseph Hall. If you missed part one, you don't want to miss part two, because part one was great, so please come out for that. Wine and cheese at 6:30 p.m. with presentation at 7 p.m. The Walking with Purpose Women's Bible Study will host a special summer session, this week on the parable of seed and sower. It'll be Thursday at 7 p.m. and then again on Friday at 8:30 a.m. in the parish center. So all women are welcome to join that very fruitful group. Our men's club is doing a cookout for the homeless at Ozenheim Inn next Saturday, July 8th. Men's Club members will meet at the shed at 8:30 a.m. to load up equipment, then head to Ozenheim Inn to cook. They plan to serve lunch at 12:30 p.m. Anyone can join for the effort to help serve lunch. And I think also some other groups, ministry groups, will be there to help minister to those at Ozenheim Inn as well. So please come out and join that. Check the bulletin for information regarding Seminary Giovanni's talk on prayer on July 12th. And also the movie Life Mark on Adoption and Forgiveness on July 19th. The church office and chapel are closed for the 4th of July holiday and will reopen with regular hours this Wednesday. Our school summer camp and summer cabbage ball are off this whole week. That's it. You may stand for the final blessing and dismissal. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now, before I send you forth, very important announcement I forgot. This is Hospitality Weekend, so please join us for some hospitality. Go forth, the Mass is ended. St. Michael the Archangel, we have protection against the wickedness and sinners. May God forgive the humble and pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast the hell of Satan, all the Holy Spirit, who God love the world, seeking the Lord's soul.
Please join in singing our closing hymn in your Bread Gather hymnal, number 872, America the Beautiful, number 872.